be very careful.
All right, guys, over here.
These are bombs, and there are six bombs. Now, sometimes the bomb squad, when they get called in, some of the bombs are duds. You know that? Some, you know, they have to try to take apart. Do you not like the pop balloons? Okay, so you're going to hold your fingers in your ears? Okay, well, then we'll get somebody else. Okay, another older girl that will don't care about popping balloons. Okay, well, you guys have, well, it doesn't matter if you have tickets or not. Do you have a ticket? Well, it doesn't matter if you have a ticket or not. Okay, come on. Okay, so there are pieces of the memory verse in these bombs, but two of them are duds. Two of them have blank pieces of memory, okay? And the rest of them have words written on them that say the memory verse, okay? So you want to grab these balloons and pop all of them as fast as you can and get the pieces of paper out of them. Two of them's going to be blank, the rest of them's going to have the memory verse on them. So get the memory verse in work as fast as you can.
Are you ready, girls?
Okay.
Are you ready, children?
Yep.
On your, help each other out, on your mark, get set, jumpy over there, aren't we? Go!
That is off limits.
friends were going to go roller skating down the new sidewalk that they had just poured in front of the school. If Casey knew, he wasn't supposed to stay late. He was supposed to come straight home from school. So when his buddies asked him to stay and skate, Casey said, "No, I'm not allowed. I've got to get home. Mom says there's going to be a storm that's coming, and I have to get home before the storm hits."
"Ah, Casey's mom says he's going to get home. You're just a mama's boy. Casey's a mama's boy. Casey's a mama's boy."
That did it. That made Casey mad. He took out his skates from his backpack, and he started lacing them up. He was going to stay and go skating. He wasn't having them boys call him a mama's boy. Casey had learned a whole bunch of new tricks, too. So down through the sidewalk, he started skating away. When he got to the edge, he made a big circle and turned around. Oh, it was a cool trick Casey had done. And the boys thought he was great. So did the girls. Boy, Casey was really popular in school. Then all of a sudden, one of the girls looked up to the sky.
"Oh no! It looks like there's going to be a big storm. I better get home."
Casey knew he was in trouble. There was a storm coming, and his mama said that he had to be home fast. Casey knew the only way to get home fast without getting in trouble was to take the shortcut. Railroad tracks. The way home by the railroad tracks was super, super short. If he could just go down the railroad tracks really fast, then he could make it home in time before the storm. So Casey started running down the railroad tracks as fast as he could, running, 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 running. But then the storm started coming, and hail started coming down from the sky. Big hail balls, ice chunks, and they were hitting Casey on the arms and on the face. Oh, they stung, and they hurt really bad. Not only did they hurt Casey's face, they started making the railroad ties really slippery. Casey knew he had to be careful, so he started jumping from one railroad tie to the other so he could get home as fast as he could without falling. Boy, these railroad ties were getting slippery. All of a sudden, out from underneath of him, his foot slipped, and Casey went flying, boom, down onto the ground. Oh, he hit his back right on the railroad ties. Boy, that hurt. He should have listened to Mama. He shouldn't have disobeyed and ran down the railroad tracks. Casey got up and started off. Oh, no. His foot, his tennis shoe had slipped in between the railroad ties and was caught. Casey started tugging and tugging and tugging at his foot. He couldn't get his tennis shoe loose, so he knew he had to get his foot out of there and get home. He didn't care whether he went home with just a sock on his foot. So Casey started untying his tennis shoe, and then the wind started. Woo! Casey started praying. Casey's foot free of the tennis shoe as the train tracks went right over, our train wheels went right over the trail, the tennis shoe laying on the tracks. Whew. That was close, Liz. As she gathered Casey up in her arms and off toward the house, she started carrying him. When Mama put Casey in bed, she was starting to making some warm oatmeal out in the kitchen. And Casey looked out in the kitchen. He could see Mama. See on her face? She had scratches on her face and her arms were bleeding. Casey knew Mama had ran through the woods when she heard him calling her name. Mama! Mama! And the trees had went against her face and cut her. And the hail that was coming down had scratched her arms and face just like his. Casey remembered what he heard in church about how that Jesus had bled and died, not just took scratches, but stripes. His back was whipped for Casey's sins, Casey's disobedience. Casey knew Mama. She didn't care whether she got hurt or not because she wanted to save Casey. Just like Jesus, he saved us. He saved our lives because he knew that we could not save ourselves. Casey got down by his bed with Mama, and Mama prayed with Casey and thanked Jesus for protecting him, for keeping him safe, and helping him to get his life spared, and that he was able to get his foot out of the tennis shoe just in time. Casey knew that Jesus had paid the price for him, just as his mama had paid that price that day when the westbound train was coming past his house. And you know, boys and girls, Jesus has paid the price for our sins. If you've not asked Jesus to come into your heart, wash all of your sins away, that's what you need to do tonight. Jesus paid the price to save you. That would be awful if we said that we didn't want Jesus' salvation, wouldn't it? Yes. Aren't you thankful that Jesus loves us and paid the price for our sins? I sure am.
I am too, friend Andrew.
Oh, you know what?
What's that?
That story was kind of sad a little bit.
It was. But it was good at the end because he got saved. You know what? Sin always makes us sad, but Jesus makes us glad.
Right, and I'm glad he does.
So let's stand up. While you're standing up, I'm going to fix this really quick. So, how many's happy tonight? Oh, good. Turn it on here. If you're happy. Don't smile, Jason.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
If you're happy and you know it,
clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, then your face will show the show. And if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. If you're happy and you know it,
then your face will show the show.
If you're happy and you know it, say it again.
Amen!
If you're happy and you know it, say it again.
back there. Help Dr. Sherlock Holmes look at some evidence, and I'll be right back. Just be real patient, and I'll be right back.
Oh,
goody, goody, goody! that's not very nice of me. I'm sorry, Horace. Don't you want me to go talk to Saul about Jesus and lay hands on him? I'll lay hands on him, all right. Put that stuff down. Oh, I can't even see. Sorry, Horace. I know, but I just can't do it. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye. There's no way. There's no way I'm going to go talk to Saul. That's pretty scary.
Boys.
All right. You want to come help me?
No.
another girl. Anyone help? Okay, girls. One, two, three, and then you need one more girl.
Take it.
Awesome.